Excel 2007 offers many file formats for exporting data to be used in other applications. You do this by saving the file in a different file format. So if you come up to your Office button and select that, and then pull down to Save As and simply choose the Save As menu option without choosing any of the submenus, this will open up the Save As dialog box. And notice you can come down here to your Save As type, and when you select this, you get a whole list of file formats that you can save your workbooks in. Some of the more popular ones are the Tab Delimited or text file format, as well as Comma Delimited, which is the .csv format. You can also save it as XML data or as the Data Interchange format or DIF format, which are all very popular and allow you to then pull your data into many other types of applications. And you do that all through the Save As dialog box. I'm going to cancel out of here. Now let's open up your product list, which we are working on in the previous movie, or you can open up 0912 start file, which you'll find in the Excel 2007 course directory in the Chapter 9 folder. Notice that we have one column here that we need to complete, and then we can go ahead and export this data in Tab Delimited format or text format. Let's go ahead and calculate what our current inventory is. So what we're going to do is choose our starting inventory here and subtract week 1, week 2, week 3, and week 4 from that. So set your cursor in H4 and then start this off as a formula by typing in an equal sign and then select cell C4 for our starting inventory for our first row of data. Then let's go ahead and subtract the sum and go ahead and type in sum parentheses and then set your range here to go from week 1 to week 4 in row 4. So you click at D4 and drag all the way across to G4 and then type in your closing parenthesis for your sum and enter that. And notice immediately Excel calculates what all of your remaining product number or quantities are by subtracting the range of week 1 through week 4 from our starting inventory. Well, now we have our product list complete. Let's export it in Tab Delimited format. So come up here to your Office button, select that, pull down to Save As and select that. In the Save As dialog box, come down to the Save As type drop down menu, select that, and go ahead and choose the Tab Delimited format or .txt. When you select that, notice that down here your file name has changed to have the .txt file extension. Go ahead and make sure you're saving in your Chapter 9 folder in your Excel 2007 course directory and choose Save. This will convert this into text format. But due to the fact that we have multiple worksheets in this workbook, Excel is now asking you if it's okay to save only the active sheet because the .txt format or Tab Delimited format doesn't support multiple workbooks. Well, this is exactly what we want. Go ahead and click OK, and then you'll get another message saying that By saving this in text format, we are going to lose some of the features that are present in our workbook, which is fine. We are looking to just export our data, not worrying about having all the formatting or the table feature or any of those other features that we've applied to our workbook or in our worksheet here. So go ahead and just say OK, and Excel will save that in tab delimited format in your Chapter 9 directory. Go ahead and check it out by exploring or navigating to that directory and taking a look at what is there in the text format. This has been quite a full chapter of working with the various data management handling tools. We've covered quite a bit on tables, as well as how to use tables to manage your data, to validating data, to exporting our data, and we looked at also how to link worksheets and workbooks together through links and external references. You are now equipped with quite a few Excel skills to move on in your Excel and workbook and worksheet development. Let's move on to the next chapter.